Do you want to turn your one-pager report into unlimited reports with just some tweaks? This awesome trick is going to help you to get rid of all the redundant work of duplicating the reports and, most importantly, help you to make your report super easy to maintain. In the previous video, we talked about how we can use a custom link to provide a safe view for your users to view the report. This opens up endless possibilities on how you can fine-tune the browsing experience for your users. While the previous method gives us a better control on how we filter the report for our users, but it actually incurs the manual work. So in today's tutorial, you will discover how you can generate unlimited lists of report links using URL parameters in Looker Studio. Here's a preview of the final outcome so you can see if this is something that you will be interested in. Users will be able to select a page from a directory page and then they will get directed to a pre-filtered report. Now I want you to take a closer look into the URL. Here I have a list of URL examples with the filters of country applied. We have United States, Thailand, and India. So I want you to observe this URL and see the similarities or the pattern in there. You will see part of the values. For example, the United States is appearing here, encoded in the URL. And for Thailand is here. And for India is actually here. So if we find a way to switch or change the values dynamically in this URL using the country field in our data set, then that would mean that we actually have a way to generate a list of dynamic URL to filter our report. Now I'm going to show you how you can use a calculator field to help you generate hundreds or thousands of reports using this URL method. So let's get into our Data Studio, and I'm going to go to edit mode and I'm going to create a field. Now this field is going to call URL. So first thing first, I'm going to just get the URL. So I'm going to just put the URL here. I'm going to remove the value Thailand, and then I'm going to add a quote here and then separate them with a comma, then add in the value country. So this is the link that I will want to compute, but I need a formula to combine these strings together. So the formula is actually called CONCAT. So just type in CONCAT and wrap the text with parentheses, and you will get this link generated. So now I'm going to click save and finish. Then I will open a new page called directory, and I'll create a simple table with country and also the URL. So now I'm going to wrap the text in my table body so that I can see the full URL. Now this is the URL that we have computed, but we are not sure if it's working or not. So what I will do is to copy this link and put it here in my browser and see if the filters apply. So as you can see, the filters already applied when I direct myself to this link. So next thing, I want to make it user friendly so that my users won't have to do the copy and pasting like what I did. I want them to have a hyperlink that they can just click from this table. What I would do is to go to edit my formula here. And this time I'm going to add a hyperlink formula, And for this hyperlink, it actually requires a URL, which we already have. And then it requires a link label. So this is the text that's going to show in the user interface. So I'm going to say click here and click update and finish. So now we have a list of reports here, and you can easily click here and filter your dashboard. So this is Allen Island, and this is for Vietnam. So we just use the hyperlink and concatenate function to help us build this URL links in a few steps. Before we end today's video, I want to share some bonus pro tips with you for staying till the end with me. So as you can see, when I showed the demo just now, there's always a filter on top that shows the country that we have filtered to. So in some cases, you might want to beautify the report, and having a filter like this may not fulfill your needs. In this case, we may want to have a dynamic title like this to show the selected country, so when the users come to this page, they know which country they are visiting. So now I'm going to go to the dashboard again, and I'm going to create a new field that call label. So now I'm going to use an if formula. If the count distinct of the country is larger than one, that means there is more than one country being selected, then I want to show as multiple countries selected. Otherwise, I want to show as the country label. So now I have the formula computed, and I can click save and finish. I'm going to go to report. And here I will just drag the dashboard title to my dashboard. And I'm going to move this filter out from my... I need to do some formatting for this scorecard. To go to style, and I want to hide the metric name, and then I would want to make the text slightly smaller. Yep. And then I can go to my directory, and we can test this out. So let's say I'm selecting this country. And you can see that the name of the country is being shown in the report, but it's slightly messy now. So I'm going to do some modification to my formula. Now I'm going to use the function concat again to tidy up my dashboard. Okay, and now I want to edit this page. So I can put it right here first. So now let's test this out with our directory. Again, I can go to this part here. And you can see that this is being shown here, but the format is a bit off, so I want to make it centered. Okay. So now let's test it again with another country, Portugal. Yep, so this is the final outcome. So that's all for today. If you enjoy this kind of content, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button so this video will reach more people like you. And I really appreciate your help. So that's all. Thank you so much. See you. Bye bye.